कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे 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 राम।
माया सुख भारम, माया सुख मीन्स इल्यूजरी हैप्पीनेस। It is actually distress, but they accept that as happiness. That is foolishness because of illusion. People want to enjoy life. Where is the enjoyment? Practically speaking, there is birth, death, old age and disease, principal sufferings, and then there are minor sufferings. Adhyatmik, adhibhautik, adhidaivik, miseries. That means miseries caused by my own body and mind, miseries caused by other living beings, and miseries caused by devatas like famine, drought, earthquake, beyond human control. Spiritual happiness is different qualities of a different quality. It is above the so-called happiness of the material world. It is not disturbed by any material condition. This is 259. Vishayagini vartante nirahārasya dehinaha rasavarjam rasopyasya parandrishtva nivartate. The embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment, though the taste for sense objects remains. But seizing such engagements by experiencing a higher taste, he is fixed in consciousness. In the material life, if I get something, if I achieve something, I become happy. If I lose something, I become unhappy. So this hankering and lamentation is going on. So, although this material life is very glaring, very attractive to us, it is actually painful. So when spiritual disciplines advocate that we give up the sense gratification, we don't want to do it. But the better way to be attracted to spiritual life is not really to stop the tendency to enjoy. It is artificial to try to stop the tendency to enjoy. Give yourself something which you will perpetually enjoy. That will completely satisfy, and byproduct, you will not be interested in material sense gratification. Automatically, nobody needs to tell you that don't do this, don't do that. You automatically don't want to do it because you have a higher taste. Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.11. Loke vyavayamisha madhya seva nityahi jantor nahitat prachodana vyavasthitisteshu vivaha yajna suragrahai rasu nivritti rishta. In this material world, the conditioned soul is always inclined to sex, meat eating and intoxication. Therefore, religious scriptures never actually encourage such activities. Although the scriptural injunctions provide for sex through sacred marriage, for meat eating through sacrificial offerings, and for intoxication through the acceptance of ritual cups of wine, such ceremonies are meant for the ultimate purpose of renunciation. Because the devotees, they know that we are eternal. This is just a brief flash in time, a period of time, that's it. So therefore they do not waste time in this. Rather, they spend time in Krishna consciousness. Those in the pubs and clubs, they also try to do this. They sing and dance. But what they get after that is a hangover. But we enjoy. Next day we are again dancing in the morning, 5 a.m. They're 5 a.m. flat out. So this is the difference. Because this is spiritual life. Susukham kartumam. We are not asking anybody to stop dancing or stop singing. No. Enjoy. But enjoy with Krishna. That's all. That is spiritual life. Whatever you are doing, do it with Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.